Okay, today I want to talk about a solution to stop frozen screens, blue screens or crashed computers. I'm going to show you an easy way to find the tasks which are responsible for these problems and how to shut them down in the background. No loss of work and no frozen or crashed systems anymore. For instance, this is a screen recording of my computer with my mobile phone. And it's showing a so-called frozen screen. I can't move forward or backwards. My keyboard didn't respond anymore, even as my mouse. And a Ctrl-Alt-Delete shortcut didn't respond. It's a Windows 7 system and it should run properly, but there's something wrong. It's also very hard to discover which task is responsible for this. Because after starting up the system again, you don't know where to look for. And when you take a view in Task Manager with Control Shift Escape, you will discover a lot of running tasks. But which is responsible for this, blue screen, frozen screen or computer crash, is absolutely one big question. With Control Shift Escape shortcut, you go to Task Manager. It can take days, weeks or months to figure out which file or task is the cause of the crash, so you don't know where to start. But as said, I have some good news. There is an easy solution to find out which process is responsible for the crash. And the best part is, it's a free tool and if used properly, you never have any crash again. So let me show you the solution I found. First go to Google and type in restart on crash. Restart on crash. Okay, this is the proper one. Reshadow.com. And you see over here reshadow.com and slightly advanced computer stuff. And more magic, and some magic. And over here you see automatical restart crash on hanged application. And over here you see the file and the description for this file, how to use it. Over here you can download the restart on crash. It's a zip file. After the unzip process, go to the file, and as you can see, it's a small one, restart on crash action. The other file is the file where the settings are stored in. As you see over here, when I started, there is no installation or anything else, so it's a very small one and can put on USB or anywhere else. As you see over here, I have started the application and you see an add, delete, settings and show lock option. So I will use the add option. Over here Explorer is already added and I will add another application or task, just how you name it, which is running in the background. So you click add, select a running application or select a file, but in this case select a running application, and you get the same screen as Task Manager, almost the same screen. Let's pick a GROME action and OK, and now it's been monitored in case of a problem with the GROME application. I know for instance that a specific file gave me some problems, and that's Winamp. So I will add it too, to show you what happens. So I go back to add, select a running application, and this is Winamp. Okay, and when I close Winamp, something weird happens. Crashed. And it's restarting again. so I will shut it down again, and it's crashing again. I don't know what the cause is, but Winamp caused me problems and will crash my computer and will give me a frozen screen, so I will install Winamp to get this problem solved. There is one option over here, which is very important to discover which task is responsible for the crash, and that is a show log. And over here you will see that Winamp caused the crash and hanged, and Winamp has been recovered. So it's easy to analyze what the problem is. Therefore, you have to go to settings and log event to a file. Choose the file and name it as you like. And this one is also important. Run restart on crash when Windows starts. So you have an analyzing option continuously. So let's recap. This frozen screen was caused by Winamp, and restart on crash did help me to find out what the problem was. You can add as much as applications or tasks as you want. There's no limit to it. You can easily uncheck or delete the tasks, so it's very convenient. And besides that, your computer will kill and shut down the software which is responsible for this crash. For more tips, go to the link above.